Being praised by a parent is one of the biggest boosts a child can get. But is there a right way and a wrong way to go about it? On the Coffee Group today, we are joined by parenting advisor John Cowan, and welcome for the first time, teen parenting specialist Yvonne Godfrey. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Morning. Now, Yvonne, let's start with you. How important is praise?
It's very important. I mean, we all want to be valued and appreciated. And I would say that praise to your emotional health is like air to your physical health. I mean, to children, their parents are the most important people in their world, and so they want to be appreciated by their parents, for sure.
And we're not just talking little children, are we? We're talking teenagers
as well. All ages, even adult children.
Yeah, everyone likes a bit of praise. John, what does praise do for a child?
It boosts their ego, it gives them a sense of who they are, and one of the nice things is that praise echoes, so that if you praise them for doing something right, the next time they do it right, even if you're not there praising them, they hear the echo in their head and they praise themselves.
What about, is there a wrong way to praise?
Yeah, when it's fake, when it's overdone, when they know it's just clattering out of your mouth and it doesn't mean anything.
Oh, good job, John, you're so good at that. I get you, that sort of thing.
Yeah, but I still want you to say it.
Oh. if it's considered to be a manipulation tactic, because they pretty quickly figure it out.
What sort of thing are you talking about?
You're really good at cooking, so it would be great if you would cook tonight. You know, they might but in their heart they think, I'm not a good cook, she just wants me to cook. She just wants me to do some work around the place.
Okay, it's possible I have used that tactic in the past. I'm trying to, at least it hasn't worked very successfully. So what are the best things we can say to our children?
I think if you speak your children's character, that's important because it's believable. If they're a particularly kind child or compassionate child and you say, that was a really kind thing to do, it resonates because it's real, so they believe it. I think it's good to talk about their progress, not look for perfection, and to acknowledge specific behaviour. Because then they want to repeat that behaviour.
Yeah, the good behaviour, not the bad behaviour.
The good behaviour.
And researchers have distinguished between what they call people praise and process praise. Mm. If you praise someone for their height or their looks or their intelligence or skill, there's nothing they can do to control those things. They're just attributes of themselves. And if you praise a child, though, for their progress, for their effort, for their character, for their choices, then it really seems to make a difference to a child in that they know that they can improve, that they can grow, that they can conquer problems. And there's been some very interesting research on this distinction between praising a kid for what they are and what they do.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing too, isn't it? I know a lot of people praise, I hear them with my children go, oh, you're such a cute little boy.
And they're not always going to be cute.
You're so handsome. And I think, well, you can't dine out on that forever, love.
Well, no, because when they go through the teenage years and they get all gangly, then we all know they've got knees like puppies, these massive knees. I've got a grandson that's got knees like a puppy right now.
Yes.
And so you can't dine out on that, because then when things change, then am I no longer cute? Which means, am I no longer acceptable to you?
Do I don't have any value?
That's right.
You've got to praise those good characteristics, that kindness,
and their choices and actions.
And the good character, if you praise that, it can be it can really cover the ones that are not so good, because they know that, wow, if I develop that, probably some of the things that are not so good about me will naturally correct.
Okay, what about over praising? Is there such a thing?
Oh, well, John would say that you can't praise enough.
Well, I'd say you can overpraise, but if you're going to make a mistake, I'd err on the side of too much rather than too little.
I think if you get to the stage where a child will only perform if they're praised, then you've got a problem. Yeah. If everything has to have praise before it happens, then I think you're starting to get into a problem area. Because life is not going to praise them. You might praise them at home, they get out into the real world and there's not a lot.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
So you've got to be able to function just because it's what you do.
It's a sign of a good boss, though, isn't it, when they do praise your work?
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, we all need it.
We do. My director's just said in my ear that I'm amazing.
And you are. You got what we were talking about there.
What about harsh words? Do they undo the praise that you've done?
Well, especially if it gives the sense that you're not sincere when you are giving your praise. Yeah. I mean, there are times when you give, you have to do correction and discipline. And
it's a lot of those times.
Yeah, you can undo it if you give the idea that, what you really think is that I'm rubbish.
It can be confusing.
Yeah.
But I think correct in private and praise in public is a good motto to have. So that when you're having that one-on-one correction time, there's no audience. Sometimes parents can be really harsh if they know there's an audience, because they're trying to look like the
That we're doing the right thing.
They're trying to look like the staunch parent, and that the ego can get out of whack there. But correct in private and praise in public is a good way to go.
Okay, so parents, we need to be thinking about how we're praising and doing the right kind of praising.
Thoughtful.
You were both great today.
Oh, gee, thank you.
No, I mean that sincerely too. You really were. That was really interesting. And
Good friends.
You're good friends, and it shows.
Yeah.
Thank you both so much for coming on the show today.
Thank you.